couple of announcements. Always remind you, Paul says, first of all, prayers. So as we have public worship, we want to say thank you to our Lord Jesus Christ, the reason why we even meet here, why we have a relationship, why we can pray to God the Father, is because of the Lord Jesus. So pray, thanking him for his marvelous grace. Pray for your brothers and sisters in Christ. Toby and Michelle are ministering to the, Toby is, and Michelle, his wife, they're back in Stockton ministering to the youth. Great ministry there, great work for the Lord. So he does that the first Sunday of each month, what this is. So be in prayer for them. Sister Denise is out with her husband, Jim. Be in prayer for them. She texted me this morning. And her friend Elaine, who came to the study on Wednesday, she said she enjoyed the study, although it was a deeper study, deeper topical study. She said she enjoyed it and wanted to come back. So be in prayer, because the first thing Satan wants to do, if someone shows interest in the grace message or learning from a minister who teaches God's grace message, the mystery, he wants to throw roadblocks, spiritual roadblocks, to discourage them from coming. So we want to be in prayer for Elaine and for all the brothers and sisters in Christ. Pray for your civil authorities as well. Just remember, this is temporal. Although this world frustrates you, the unrighteousness of it, of our leaders, we're to pray for them, okay? Titus chapter 3. If you want to give people who like to do that, you can do that at our P.O. box in the mail or online at our websites. You guys, there's the box. I put this because I've had brothers and sisters say that based upon this verse in 1 Thessalonians 5:13, they really appreciate our labor in the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 5:13, they esteem us very highly in love for the work's sake. People appreciate the work of Norcalgrace. The saints here, we're a unit, we're a family. And so I've had brothers and sisters say that based upon that verse, they really do esteem us very highly in love, and we appreciate that. Pray for us and give. That's how you can support us. Get a little feedback before we get going. This one says, hi, Brother Ron and Sister Krista. And I'd answered a question for this particular saint. Thank you so much for your in-depth topical study on the above referenced subject. It was a study I did. Many of you over here. It was called Remember Lot's Wife. And I can't remember. Maybe it was a Wednesday night study. Remember Lot's Wife. They go on to say, it ministered to me personally on so many levels, i.e. not looking back. Lot's wife looked back, and the Lord says, don't look back to that. Let it go. Thinking also on what Paul says in Philippians 3, this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before, pressing forth. Then they go into some other personal reflections about how it affected them, you know, some details about their life I'm not going to really put out there. They go on to say, notwithstanding, it is still a joy to have the free time to be with family, to learn, and to study the word. I am not whining or complaining. I'm just pointing out how timely that study is of not looking back. The other thing you mentioned was Jacob's ladder and his dream. That's from the book of Genesis, I believe chapter 32. Also mentioning how God the Father used to live here on earth. Yes, the Godhead lived here right on earth till the flood. This wasn't the only time I heard this from your messages. What an interesting study that would be. Maybe I'll touch on that in the future on one of our Wednesday night studies. Another saint had an idea I'm going to talk about. Even little words like little words unto and to and different things like that. You start to see something over the course of years of studying your King James Bible. I may bring that one up on our next Wednesday night study. But anyway, she says, this wasn't the only time I heard this from your messages. What an interesting study that would be, that God actually lived here on earth. I would love to learn more on this, so I may do it in the near future. When I consider the beauty of his earthly creation, I can only imagine that he did live here in it, and he did. Okay. Finally, it was a delight to see the display of joy and jubilation by the saints at Norcalgrace when Ryan returned. He is truly loved. Yes, he is. Once again, thank you. Take care. Grace and peace. So it must have been a Sunday. No, when did you come? Was it a Wednesday or a Sunday? He walked in here, and I embraced him. He's not really a hugger, but I'm gonna give him one anyway when he's gone for 3 months. So, people, I got a lot of people. They got a little emotion about this. As far as it was good to see that natural reaction when he walked in, and we all saw him for the first time in a few months. And speaking of Ryan, he's catching up on the studies as well on a nice pace, okay? He had a lot of work to do since he got back, besides his own secular work with his sunshineinabottle.com. Go there and get your olive oil. But he is catching up with the studies, so be in prayer for him. And thank God for Brother Ryan. We couldn't be the ministry we are outside of these four walls without his labor in the Lord.